Friday. It is just after 6. I'm about to go get a tattoo. Lots of meetings today. It was not a chill Friday like I had planned for, but that's just fine. Gang, so I oh my tire's sliding. I'm on my way into the city. I'm gonna get a tattoo. That's where I'm at in life. Good God. My car is acting like it wasn't gonna make it. But yeah, so it's Friday. It's like 7:20. I'm heading into the city to get a tattoo. Can't wait. It was really like last minute. It just came over me. And guys, I feel like every time I have a tattoo, I'm like going through a phase. Oh bitch, you did not just make a U-turn like that. Yeah, so I'm gonna go get a tattoo. This weather sucks. It's like so cold and rainy. I know y'all can see and hear it. The real tea is I still have work that I like need to get done, and I just like need to step away. Like I'll be trying to do everything all in one day, like all in a day's work, and like all the time. Like I never, it is really raining. I just be trying to do everything like all at once. Like I think I have to do everything. Like I really never just take a step back to like really step back and like enjoy the not working time, because I'm just like always working on something. So I'm trying to get better about that and just like carve time out for myself. Yeah, I got a tattoo and it hurt like shit. I don't know if you guys have ever had your fingers tattooed, but like literally getting my fingers tattooed, hands down worst tattoo I've gotten. Now granted, my only other tattoos are like little ones on my forearms, like random things. Fingers definitely took the cake. Like when he got to these dots by my cuticles, it literally felt like a razor blade was being taken to my finger and my finger was being sliced right down the middle. That's what it felt like. But beauty equals pain and I love it. All right, y'all. I was just talking to my mom. Apparently she's making dinner and wants me to come out there, but I don't feel like driving out there. I feel like all I do is drive. Now that I've moved like out to the west suburbs, like they're like, come out here, come out here. And I'm like, I hear you, child, but that is a 45-minute drive that I'm not trying to make. So, whatever. So, today's agenda, I'm going to go to Ikea, maybe Home Goods. Just want to get some things. I'm about to get in the shower. I had to get some work done, so I got that done. I got that out of the way, but now it's like almost 12 o'clock, so we showered. I was dragging my feet and then like low-key gave myself like anxiety. Like y'all ever do that? Like you be stressing yourself out. Like I was literally sitting there and like, oh my God, it's going on whatever time. It's going on 12 o'clock. I need to hurry up. I need to hurry up and get going. I literally don't have anything like planned today. Why am I stressing myself out talking about, oh my God, it's going on 12 already. So whatever. Basically, I was just taking time to like be still this morning. Like I had coffee. I was just like still. Like I got some work done and then I just really took some time to just sit for a second. Like not cleaning, not running around doing something, not doing the most, like literally just sitting here. OG facial radiance pads. Glow Beauty skincare toner. I just love a facial spray. Like, y'all don't even know. Then I'm gonna go in with the Glow Beauty Hyaluronic Acid. Driving to the mall. I'm going to run to Victoria's Secret and I want to find like a little loungewear outfit or something, or like some new pajamas, just something like cozy and cute, because I feel like I have like real clothes, like, you know, going out and all that stuff, but then when it comes to like just like being around the house, I just be wearing like whatever. Like I just throw stuff on, like random sweats and random shirts. I don't have like a lot of sets. Yeah, so before this I went to Ikea and I found so much good stuff. I didn't really have a plan. I went there actually looking rugs. So there were a bunch, but on second thought, I want to go back and measure like the area that I want the rug to fill, so I don't play myself and get like too big of a rug or too small. I just want it to be like perfect. So I took some pictures of ones that I liked. I don't know if I want more of like a shaggy, like high pile rug, or there were also some like woven, like more of like an earthy kind of feel. I'm not even sure what the material is, but it was woven. So I'm trying to decide between those, but I think actually I really like the woven ones. Like they were like different but simple, and really like just like a different texture, because it's like my living room is so gray and then my couch is like a cream gray, so it's just like I feel like there's nothing like breaking it up. So I want to add more like natural tones in there. I think I actually just talked myself into a decision, and honestly it was one of the cheaper ones, because y'all, rugs can be like really expensive, and like I want a rug that's nice, but like it's not that deep. Like I do not need a rug that costs like really more than $200. I'm trying to stay within that budget, but the ones that I liked actually were under $100. So shout out to IKEA. To what I actually got, these towels. They're just super basic. Really basic, really thin towels. Some Ziploc bags, very exciting. These mugs, this jar, but these from IKEA are so freaking good. Also got this salad bowl. Been dying for like a wooden bowl. All right, up next, salad spreader. Definitely needed this. I was buying like the triple washed, all ready to go lettuce or spinach or mixed greens, whatever. But honestly, guys, this stuff tends to be more expensive. So let me stop being fucking lazy and get a salad spinner. This jar here for my coffee. Wooden spoon. This dish, it's just like a little casserole dish, but I like the size of it. Cutting board for chopping like little stuff, like a lemon. This, so I can start to like make like frothy like creamer or whatever. Fuck, I forgot batteries. Yeah, these, they're just like little cork things to place underneath. There's three of them in here. To place underneath like hot pans or like the casserole dish. It's a cookie sheet and then a liner mat for it as well. This, a 16 by 26 pillow. And then I got a cover for that. It's like a natural color. So got this throw blanket. So I also went to Ulta and Victoria's Secrets. We'll show you what I got from Ulta. Let's get into it. I went there for this and this only. Makeup will not move. Real Techniques, one of their new sponges, it's the Miracle Air Blend Sponge. It says it's supposed to blend and mattify. I don't know where I saw this. Somebody posted about this, but I was like, I gotta have it because I love the orange, the original Real Techniques sponge. That's usually what I use. So had to get this, try this out. Just some Tree Hut lip scrub. Got this e.l.f. Flawless Brightening Concealer. I just got this, I was like, on my no makeup days. This would be cute, it's like a little pencil, I think. So it'll be good for like little spots. Lashes, they're just really simple, natural lashes. This lip gloss, it's Maybelline Lifter Gloss. Hyaluronic acid, got me again. I got it in the shade Ice. This body spray, it's called, it's by Pacifica, it's Kindred Spirit. It's rose dust and Palo Santo. I don't know if I love it. Like when I, so dumb, I don't know why I bought it. But when I sprayed it in the store, I sprayed the little tester or wiped it because it was broken, Ulta. But when I wiped the tester on my hand, I was like smelling it, like it's wearing down well, but it was like real loud when I first put it on. So I didn't get the actual perfume. I just got the hair and body mist, thinking that maybe it'll be a little bit more toned down. You know the little mini section when you check out? Stay getting me. Stay getting me. NARS Creamy Concealer. I've never tried this concealer, actually. Maybe when I worked at Ulta, like, there used to be days that I would, like, do my makeup at work because I was hungover, but very different times. It's in the full size, but they were sold out, so I got this in the travel size. It's Too Faced Hangover RX Pillow Balm. It's an ultra hydrating and nourishing lip treatment. I went OD there too. She packed the fuck out of this bag. These are all the panties. They were 10 for 35. Oops. So I got this bralette. I've been wanting this, and it was on sale for 15 bucks. So it's so soft. I've been seeing like period panties become more and more popular. So I'm really excited to try these. Like, it says that it's supposed to hold absorbency level is 3 tampons. Being a girl is so hard. So I buy myself all these things to make me feel better. These pair of leggings, they're just black, nothing fancy. They're just the high-waist 7-8 leggings. I haven't bought any body hair from like Pink or Victoria's Secrets since I was like easily high school. First of all, it was 2 for $20. Second of all, it smells really, really good. Their honey and sugar line, or honey and shea butter line. So here's the tea. It's a sugar scrub. It is honey and sugar nourishing body scrub. Oh my god, it's giving warm vanilla sugar. The nourishing gel body wash. I got the lotion, the nourishing body oil. Did I need to buy all of these things today? No, I just want the vibes today. Like, happy Sunday. I'm about to head out to go see my family, hang out with them. It's Halloween. Happy Halloween. I'm not participating in the festivities this year. Aunt's making homemade lasagna tonight, and I cannot wait. I'm about to smash. And then my brother, he just moved, so he's gonna be home for the weekend. I was listening to this podcast earlier this morning, though, and it was like really, really hitting. And it was just talking about like letting stuff go and doing that for yourself, not like, because like, you know, sometimes it's like really hard to forgive people because like you're like, what you did was just so foul that I can't even forgive you. Like, I feel like me forgiving you is like doing you a favor. Forgiveness is for you. Like, me forgiving someone that did something foul is for me, it's not for them. So I welcome that idea this week. Back, like, holding on to stuff, like, it holds you back, you know. Like, it's no detriment to that other person. Like, they're foul, like, they're just being them, they're just doing what they do. But like, for me, I'm like, how could y'all possibly do that, you know? I welcome that idea of letting stuff go for me and forgiving, just forgiving myself for me, you know, what somebody else did to me. Like, that's on them to deal with. One of the vloggers that I follow, she really hit it on the head with this We the Urban quote, which is a page I follow. They post like inspirational and like motivational stuff and just like very, like, very much like self-help energy. But it was like, stop over empathizing and robbing people of the consequences of their actions, or robbing people of the experiences of girl, I'm gonna find a meme and post it because I'm about to butcher it. But I wrote it down at home and it's on my desk, you know, it's somewhere that I'll see it all the time. But it's basically like, don't over empathize and be robbing people of their karma. That's how I took it. And I always do that, you know. I'm quick to forgive, but just because I forgive someone, like, does not mean that I need to like let all my boundaries just down the drain. And that's really what I've been doing. So yeah, that meme was very thought-provoking and got me going. And then furthermore, the podcast that I was listening to this morning, like, thinking about that just made me feel better in a way, because I've really been like dealing with some stuff that I just need to let go.
52 minutes.
Two full-time jobs. So personal assistant, I'm also like project manager in the tech fulfillment space with the personal assistant work. Also handle, within the personal assistant work, I handle all social media for this business. So it's like it's two businesses. I also do social media management for another two brands. I've been blessed to like have these different like streams of income coming in, but it's like, okay, now it's time to like start reinvesting into myself. Up that stuff for work and just get like reset for the week. Hopefully I can get everything done by like 10 10:30 so I can still